Hello, everybody. Welcome to yet another episode of Insights with InMobi, where we speak and have candid conversations with Asia's marketing leaders. Today, I have with me Ranga Gandina, GM Data Solutions Business and Partnership at Telkomsel. Hello, Ranga. Welcome to Insights with InMobi.
Hi, Rajesh. Thank you so much to you and all the InMobi teams for having me today.
Awesome. We are so, so excited. For all the listeners and viewers out there, Ranga started his career in the biggest leading media agency group, where he also brought home the first medal for Indonesia itself at Young Spikes Asia. That's quite an achievement, Ranga. And he's had a hands-on experience in handholding brands during the early phase of their digital marketing era as a strategic planner. He has actually a deep interest in tech and digital, and that has led him to join the tech giants such as Tencent, then Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp. We all know about it. And he actually there helped drive conventional business transformation into data-driven marketing. And when the opportunity to grow a startup appeared, he took it and joined Adex as the CMO, where he shaped the business development marketing pillars for the company. Now, he's currently become an integral part of digital transformation and data-driven growth in Telkomsel as he leads the big data business and partnerships out here. He's really a man on the mission of driving big data as a growth lever for the greater good. And Ranga, warm welcome again. But really, you know, to start it off, really wanted to actually call out that the names that I've called out, the kind of achievements that I've, talked about, you've really had a stellar career during, you know, the entire period doing some exciting work, which is across tech, digital, and very big, big brands, right? So can you tell us a bit about your own personal journey in the digital industry, and specifically when it comes to digital marketing, data, et cetera?
Cool. Yeah, thank you so much, Rajesh. And I guess you're setting up a bit high of the benchmark. you're mentioning some things that actually it's my track, but you sell it beautifully, so thank you. But I guess, yeah, what marketing itself is always been my passion. Since I was in college, I studied marketing. One of the things why I still stuck and love being in the marketing world because it's one of the ways we touch the broader audience, we communicate to them, we share knowledge about technology, about product, enlightening the broader market and make them convinced to do the action that we want them to take, not only for the commercial part of it, but also about the moving the industry towards digitalization and transformation. So I guess that's one of the beauty of marketing, keep connected to your audience. So, but I guess the interesting part is back then when I studied it, most of the marketing side that being brought up into the study or being brought up into the media and all the fame and fortune comes towards the creative side of the marketing. Coke advertising with a beautiful TPC, all of the chocolate, all of the milk would like to battle in terms of the creative side of the marketing. Suddenly, I land my feet on the scientific side of the marketing, which is on the media agency. Back then, I didn't really know about media part of the marketing. I just thought, oh, this is another marketing side. I just would like to try and take it. After all, I just love, and I just fell in love with this side of marketing, which is currently we are quite familiar with the term of data-driven marketing. Mm-hmm. So yeah, back then I was jumped into the media side, and just like the consultant or the investment manager, we try to manage the marketing budget, which is comes from the client, towards a better spot, towards a better investment part of it to create higher and give a benefit and ROI better for the clients and for the industry.
So the entire modeling mix of sorts is what you
Correct.
Were starting to look
Correct.
At.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And how to do that, definitely we need to know what works, what didn't work, and how to scale up the good and stop the bad and all etc. And it drives then into the how we utilize the data. how we read the data, how we communicate it better, and how we use it for a decision making. And putting that and combining with the creative side of the business, I guess that what makes it more beautiful. The marketing runs better and et cetera. The campaign being delivered in terms of achieving the business, but also touching the consumer's life. So I guess it really gets me deeper and deeper into the marketing. That's maybe around 10 years back. And just right at the moment when, especially in Indonesia, and I believe in the Southeast Asia region as well, all the digital stuffs, all the digital media surging. So Google, Facebook of the world, it tries to steal the share of wallet from TV, definitely, and from other conventional media, the newspaper, the radio, and etc. And I believe right after that, all the marketing tech partner like InMobi and the others come as well into the picture. So it's getting interesting because all of these digital players make all of the data more accessible, more easily to be consumed. It's making us the marketers easier to analyze it and to take decision and how to scale up further, because now digital really break through the market by giving access towards the data. All the measurement, not only based on the feeling driven when we are taking a decision, but now it's a hard fact and hard truth. Obviously, data lies on the eyes of the beholder. So definitely, we can have a different perspective on data. But that's again another beautiful angle towards this data driven marketing. So yeah, I guess when this opportunity come, definitely I would like to know better about this side of the industry. So from the agency marketing side, now I move into the tech side. I started with Tencent when I into the tech side of the industry. I helped them bring one of their product towards Indonesia. So I becoming like the business development, but building the brand equity as well, setting up their establishment in Indonesia. And then another giant would like to build their presence stronger in the country of Facebook. And I'm just carried away getting deeper into the tech side of the world. And definitely tech can become that big and can become more impactful towards our life because of their source of data. That's why I believe not only working on the digital side of the business and the tech company, but I would like to understand deeper about data utilization. So yeah, all in all, that's what brought me into my current role. Utilizing the biggest telco in the region, if not only in Indonesia, to see how we can utilize and monetize the big data better. One of the pillars is definitely to help the marketing industry towards the data-driven marketing and data-driven growth.
Got it. Now, very interesting how actually I'll go back to the first thing that you called out, right? Not long ago, marketing was just about creativity, right? Like, how good is your creative idea? How big is it? But that brings me to a very important question, because remember, even there, everybody would actually go to the ICP, the ideal customer profile, build that. But media is still struggling with data and audiences, and they are struggling to gather that. So how do you see, you know, like in this whole evolution that you've seen over a period of decade and more, how important has it been, the idea of data utilization and tech, to get people closer to that ICP and actually the creative match the execution on media? So how important has data and audiences been over there?
I guess that's totally, how to put it, that's a totally match how you would like to know your audience better and tap the right audience for you and make them react or do something towards your business or towards your brand, there's no other way, there's no better way to do it unless you put data into that equation. So that's, I guess how can I put it? Because
so you're saying that it's primarily how brands actually want to utilize data. They should be able to build the problem statement, right? Is that what you're saying?
Correct. Because for me, to be very honest, digital, when we are saying, oh, this is a digital marketing, digital supposed to be under the roof of the marketing. Digital is only one of the vehicle. What we do is actually the marketing itself. So I'm not really a big believer that there should be someone called a digital marketer, a conventional marketer, a TV marketer. Everyone is a marketer actually. It's just a vehicle how we do it. We need to think more comprehensive and more holistically. With the main objective is to touch towards our audience. But definitely each of the business should know their objectives based on their stage of the business. And this might be the first encounter that I believe data can help. So understanding your business. So for example, you're a startup with a new product MVP. You would like to know the competition. That's the first way that you can use the data, how you map the competition using all of the available data, for example, telco data, how your competition doing certain stuff, how their campaign performing, compare it to you. Is it their churners coming to you or your churners coming to them, and et cetera, just to map out all the competition. So that's one way to put it, knowing the competition. That's one. The other one definitely is when you would like to look deeper into your audience. So who's your core and who's your
adjacent audience, maybe just, you know, not
correct. Source of growth. Yeah. Who's your source of growth? Who's your core audience? And then what do they like? What do they react to? How do you incentivize them? You can do so many stuff, getting deeper insight, doing a dipstick or quantification towards a survey and etc. There's another way to use marketing as well. And then after those two steps, definitely you would like to put your budget into some spots and then getting back the feedback data to see which one performs better and putting an experimental head or testing head towards your strategy. And then this is another use of data. You would like to map all of it and then see which one to scale, which one to stop, and which one to pivot. I guess that's how you can encounter the use of data in terms of the basic fundamental marketing activities.
I love how you've actually been able to, you know, call the use of data across the life cycle, saying you, of course, look at the basic insight, intel pieces itself, and then use it across as sources of basically setting up campaigns, optimizing campaigns, then closing the loop by reporting, et cetera, et cetera. Now, specifically to telecom cell, right? Like, it is huge. Like you said, it's like, definitely the biggest in Indonesia with 1.5 plus million subscribers and consumers. And a bunch of them are actually smartphone, really connected consumers on top of that. So the brevity and basically also the richness of data signals that are coming in is so deep, so rich, right? So how do you see for media use cases specifically, this becoming, you know, extremely important, and what are use cases that you're often seeing come up when it comes to telecom sales big data that's available to a bunch of brands?
Awesome. I guess this is quite interesting because from our perspective as a telco, as a telecom sale, we keep trying to find a better use cases. So what I can say, our use cases also based on the iteration. Because our core of business, definitely telco and connectivity. We would like to touch base into the marketing side of it because we believe we can create impact. But that's not our core. So that's why we keep doing the iteration, what the market needs. Is it something that can help them, or is it some just flashy things that just momentarily not sustainable, and etc. But I can say some of the use cases are based on, one is finding an aggregated insight. Based on our huge or subscribers, we can see a pattern out of it. So this, all of this individual, we try to see the pattern and make an aggregated insight. This is something that we can try to lay down how is the market landscape and competition of the market. So that's one of the use case. The other one of the use case is going into each individual of your audience with a sense of privacy in mind. So for example, we would like to check whether this audience falls into which group, and then clustering it into certain segment of audience that we can tap into, and we can activate it, all of those segments into one, definitely an advertising, reaching them towards the digital inventory, or the other way around is to get more insight of them by sending them sort of like the survey and getting deeper understanding about those segments, specific segments.
Like the dipstick piece you were mentioning. Yeah.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Correct. So I guess that's basically the baseline on the digital utilization of telco that we can tap into marketing. Definitely. On top of that, we can do some creative things, some iteration moving forward, and all etc.
Awesome. And I love how you've called out the idea of privacy first by design, right? That's something that is innate and inherent. Now, therein, again, I think there is a huge relevance of such data, of these third-party audience cohorts, and also to some extent, maybe personalized, customized data signals, right? And that's the reason also why InMobi and Telkom Cell itself came together to say that there is a deprecation of basically very pointed, very unique identifier happening in the ecosystem, starting with the Apple transparency framework. But how do you see actually, you know, the role of players like Telkom Cell, right, on the programmatic, on basically, you know, platforms like InMobi, when it comes to data audiences targeting because of this entire movement of privacy first?
Yeah. You call out something that's really interesting and also might be sensitive moving forward, but this is hits really in the spot actually, Rajesh, because with the oblivion of third-party data, all the advertisers also getting into this pool of digital, and the competition is getting harder and harder. Actually, what marketers need to think, and this is something that Telkomsel as a telco big data provider also would like to help, is creating a more sustainable digital marketing ways for them. Because like I previously mentioned, when we are talking about marketing, it's also digital marketing and also the other way around. And under the digital marketing itself as well, it's not only about the advertising and the targeting. Mm-hmm. We talk about getting the insights, building your CRM, building your baseline, creating your first party data pool, a measurement. All of that is falls under the effort towards a more sustainable marketing. So I guess that's one of the theme that I would like to emphasize. Telkom Cell with the big data would like to create more impact towards the marketing side of the business, technology and marketing side. We would like to help creating a more sustainable effort on data-driven marketing for everyone to achieve their objective, which is growth. So that's one thing. It entails as well on what efforts does the advertiser need to do differently, because us as big data providers cannot only just do this without the main effort from the advertiser. So I believe they also need to think about how they would like to make it more sustainable, collect only what matters, and building more a deeper relationship with the consumer and the audience. Definitely we need to be more transparent towards the customer, because data privacy is not all about we are not giving away the data, but yeah, building a deeper communication that transparently that hey, let's connect, just treat them as a human. Hey, let's connect. I would like to know you better. Definitely, if I would like to know you better, I need some information from you, and this is how we will use your information to give you a more relevant information, to create a more meaningful conversion or iteration for you, and all etc. So I guess collect only what matters and also communicate transparently. That's one thing. But in terms of communicating transparently, sometimes it's a double-edged sword, right? Towards your customer. So I guess making it enticing and incentivizing towards your customer, why do they need to connect with you and give you all the information, as in the data, we need to tell them what's in it for them, and also saying to them in a generic way, but also in a specific way.
I love how you juxtapose the two of them.
Yeah, correct. You are mentioning something too specific. Yeah. You as a marketers just need to do it all over again when another thing's coming up. So just put a generic communication, but you put it transparently on how you want to connect with them and how you will use their information moving forward. Yes, yeah.
Got it. So you're also saying that you need to keep it simple. It's like really abstracted, but it should communicate the essence of it whenever Correct. You're doing it. And this actually reminds me, right? Like you raised a very, very valid point, which is there's the trusted value exchange idea, right? I mean, one of the most basic needs of anybody within society, within community, is just that trust, right? Hey, right. I am ready to give my number to you because I trust you will act in a certain way. And this reminds me, right? Like Apple recently did the ad where they would actually just tell everybody privacy is Apple. But I also feel that, you know, in some ways that might not be the best ad, because that, for instance, if today I go, you know, in India and, you know, I basically look at someone who has come to my website as a publisher, and I tell them, right, like, hey, please share your whatever first party data or please enable ads. Yeah. They might say no. And then I'll say, sorry, I can't keep it free. If you want to continue reading or if you want to continue playing the game, please accept ads. And they'll be more than happy because they get the idea of the exchange, right? And I just love how you called it out, that if there is a trusted value exchange and transparent communication, consumers will come on board. Otherwise, it always remains very abrupt and neither party wins across the board, right?
Correct. Totally. I guess just one additional, Rajesh, because you put it, your answer is interesting to trigger my mind further, is because when we're talking about building a more sustainable way for this data-driven marketing, is, you put it beautifully, building the trust. Because the marketing way back then, it might be a product push, and that's why it falls under the more transactional way. And we are just trapped too long thinking about people just need to buy the stuffs. It's ended that way. People just need to buy the stuffs. It's becoming transactional. The conversion is just happening after the purchase. But it should be beyond that. We should build the trust, build a deeper connection. And how to do that is connect with the relevant audience, with the relevant offering from the brands and the right communication. once the trust is built, definitely it's going to be a long term. We can talk about loyalty, we can talk about advocacy, the further down below the funnel after the conversion, I guess.
Awesome. No, I think the idea of long term is most important because, like you said, sustainability cannot be a near term option. It cannot be a short term thing. And with the pace of evolution that's happening, it's just, you know, you always have to be here and now, but think of the long term. And with that, like, I think one of the other questions also, right, like as a telecom player and like as a big, big data owner, how are you thinking of the next 2 to 5 years when it comes to big data utilization, right? And activation of this? I know you already called out that's an iterative process and a lot is still in the works, but would love to just hear where you see this entire thing going in the future.
Yeah. That's actually one of the toughest questions that you just throw to me in the past these minutes. Let me think a bit on that because... Yeah, I guess currently what we're doing is based on the iteration. We would like to see how the market moves and then not becoming reactive, but would like to respond on what market needs. While in this at the same time we try to read the pattern and put something projection on where this market would like to go. But it's not going to be an easy job, to be very honest. And seeing 2-5 years is hard.
No, I agree.
In this period of time, right? When all of the information access is blown up, everyone knows everything. So everyone can just pivot in the next minutes. So predicting is quite hard. But let me share a bit of what I have in mind.
Mm-hmm.
On the standpoint of the marketers, this might sound basic, but I guess we haven't done fully of this in terms of the concept is how we can utilizing timely the data that we have towards a data-driven decision makings on how we can bring the customer along the journey of the funnel. Because back then, when marketing still simpler, we have this funnel like awareness, interest, desire, and action. Now it's being extended into loyalty, into advocacy, and all etc. But the concept still there that we need to handhold our customers toward each of the stages in the funnel. And actually, each of the funnel consists of a different set of activities, a different set of responses, and a different set of audiences. Actually, because from the bigger funnel comes into the smaller funnel, we understand the concept, but when it comes to the data and how we bring them along the journey, sometimes the data itself is having a lack of time. So your previous campaign, you need to digest the data, and then you need to create the next decision is taking a longer way and a longer time lead. So I'm thinking having a timely process of consuming data and also analyzing it and utilizing it towards data decision making gonna be quite important. So I guess the keyword is timely. Mm-hmm. So that's what. The other thing is definitely again, I'm speaking in terms of the concept. I still would like to embrace the marketer to put your audience first in mind and treat them not only as a number but also as a human, as the subject, not as an object. And if you start thinking that way, you will put yourself in the shoes of the audience. And then it's becoming more interesting because thinking from the audience perspective, how the advancement of data and marketing technology would impact them is, I'm thinking out loud now, one is seamless to commerce.
Mm-hmm.
So once us as the audience, one us as a consumer get in touch or connected towards the brand or the business, I would like to have a frictionless effort to do the commerce.
Yeah.
Because the better way, the more seamless, the more frictionless, definitely the lesser people they would like to drop off on your process and giving better ROI. Another one, definitely to support those seamless to commerce is giving a contextual creative. Previously we have the concept of dynamic creative optimization and etc. It's there, but it's not being utilized fully. Like I mentioned previously, if this contextual creative can be mapped out into each of the funnel, definitely it's helped the seamless commerce. It's helped into the customer retention. It helps bring better ROI. And one of the last thing that I have in mind actually is with the emerging of AR, VR, metaverse, and etc. is how the consumer, how the audience can be fully immersive toward real actions when being in touch with the brands or the marketing effort, marketing activities or advertising or whatsoever. It should be enabling them toward immersive experience toward real actions, be it purchase, like we previously mentioned, be it understand the product better when they would like to know in a more interactive way, in a more meaningful way, utilizing all of the Web3 emerging and all etc. But yeah, immersive toward real actions, that's what I have in mind.
Awesome. I love how you called out that near real-time decision-making data lies, but it's not really surfacing to help you do it across the life cycle. You're taking each block, you're doing a campaign, you're pushing it separately, but you should be able to, using telco big data, achieve that kind of an efficiency over a period of time. I hopefully as a marketer myself, I'm really looking forward to that day where we can actually leverage a bunch of those and really, really would love to, segue from one campaign into other in almost real time, and hoping, you're pioneers in that and you're getting us closer every day with whatever you do.
But just don't put too much pressure on me and on us.
Just a little bit, Ranga, just so that our listeners can get back to you and ask you more questions in 2 years' time about all of this. But just as a last question, as a closing question, because we are here in here and now, and we want to actually have the listeners understand in 2-3 simple steps, how can they leverage the big data of Telkomsel on InMobi? What would be those 2-3 steps that you would let them know? And with that, we can basically close the interview.
Sure. Awesome. I might take a step back and not mentioning the 2-3 steps specifically on digital marketing or the platform. I might try to connect it with our partnership, Telkomsel and InMobi, but as a marketer, I experience it on the agency side, on the brand side, and also on the platform and on the data provider side. I try to make it simpler when we try to solve the marketing problem or the business problem. Actually, I have those three steps being condensed into Mosaic. What I call is Mosaic, the MOSAIC. Actually, so first, I just take a step back and thinking, what is the marketing objective? So the MO is the marketing objective. It sounds cliche, but if you don't understand what's the North Star and what would you like to get, you will be lost in translation because all of this data and digital is so
expensive,
correct, and expensive and all that. So realize first what is your marketing objectives. Connect it with your current condition, your life cycle of the product, your stages of the business, and where would you like to move from point A to point B. Define that first, the marketing objective, and then after you're quite clear on the marketing objectives, move into the SA, which is the strategic audience. Thinking on who's your core audience, who's your the peripheral audience, who's your source of growth, and how you can connect with them better. Do you want to do a different treatment towards your each of the funnel segment or your core versus your source of growth? Define first your strategic audience. And then after you know the objective, you know the audience, the last one is IC, actually, from the Mosaic framework that I mentioned previously, is the insightful context. This is where thinking your audience as a human, treat them as a subject, understanding all of the creative thinking, putting into work, and also listening as well, what is happening in the market, right on into that momentum, right on into that news, interesting memes or whatsoever, putting those insightful context into your audience, and thinking about how the marketing objective can be achieved towards them. The rest, I guess, is gonna be the vehicle towards it. And definitely one of the vehicle is because I'm working on it, you, Rajis, working on it, and we create a partnership out of it. Definitely use what's available on the market in terms of getting a sense of the insight and how to touch the consumer better. For example, like our partnership, Telkomsel can provide the insights and also who's your audience, who's your audience, and then activate it towards the marketing technology platform that's already one of the best in the market, which is InMobi. So thinking first about the framework and then how to achieve that, thinking what's best vehicle towards achieving that. I'm going to be a salesman, you thinking about Telkomsel and InMobi, and see what it brings your campaign towards a better part of your marketing side, and then iteration, putting your testing mindset and iterate it, because there's no such thing as it's success now or it's fail now, and it will be keep success or keep fail in the next phase. You just need to keep iterating.
Awesome. No, really love the Mosaic framework. I think you've kind of summed up our interview in that beautiful framework for everybody. That really like kind of brings us to an end. It was, I know like time has just flown by. It was really a pleasure hosting you, Ranga. We will, of course, figure out how to get you back on Insights with InMobi, because I think you're an endless pool of basically insights yourself. And we will look forward to really hosting you once again on Insights with InMobi. Thanks a lot for making time out.
I'm the one who should thank you and the InMobi teams, Rajesh. This is such a rare moment to have a deep discussions with one of the best marketing tech platform in the region. And having this discussion is just make me rethink again what we've done previously and how we come, how we achieve into these stages and et cetera in terms of the marketing. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I know a bit of nostalgia would have hit you, right? Like at the start.
Right.
But lovely again to have you. Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you, Rajesh.